test. We back at it. Quarantine gameplay. I heard quarantine is supposed to end, at least in Michigan, in a couple of days, but don't worry, if you enjoy these gameplays and you want to see the end, I'll finish the game. Let's get started from where we left off.
These people should not have been sent here. It's not safe.
Manned space travel is not safe. Since mankind first entered space, the debate has raged over the value of manned space travel. There is a large contingent of the ISA that believes all tasks that need to be performed on Europa could be performed by machines. It is obviously less risky to send machines rather than humans into space.
Puzzles are getting harder and harder.
We sent drones to Earth's moon. Scientists can remotely operate drones. If we did it there, why not here too?
Teleoperation became possible on the moon when the communication latency was reduced to 1.4 seconds. The distance between the Earth and Earth's moon is approximately 1.3 light seconds. This enables near real-time control of drones by scientists. The story is different with Europa, as the distance between Earth and Jupiter oscillates between approximately 32 and 53 light minutes. It takes a very long time for Earth to communicate with Europa. Due to that distance, teleoperation will never be possible on Europa.
Okay, but why not control drones from the satellite?
Why not indeed? My systems can be teleoperated from Europa's satellite. That is when the communication lines are open. However, the advantages of human field workers, apparently, outweigh the risks.
So, why can't you solve these tests, Tom?
I am not permitted to think laterally. Parts of my systems are permitted to use evolutionary algorithms. This simulates what is called creativity. However, evolutionary algorithms can converge on inefficient and ethically suboptimal solutions. Since this is the case, I am only permitted to take actions in response to a set of constraints.
What do you mean by morally suboptimal?
Solutions to problems that transgress ethical boundaries.
keep having to remember. Is that the things I need to solve the puzzle are in the room. I just need to remember that. I'll be able to solve the puzzle if I could just remember that. It's just hard to remember that sometimes. Sometimes you be thinking like, nah, man. Give me enough stuff. But they gotta be. Because they want you to beat the game, man. This happens every other gameplay. The last. But I put the orb last. I think I messed up. I can't take this out. Oh, Lord have mercy. So, I mean, they're getting harder. That's what she said. Two. need that power box right there. There's gotta be a way to take it with me. Get out of here. Sit down. Oh, man, this here. This one. So this is what I gotta take with me. Chill. Grab this one and this one. Boom. I'm pretty smart. When I first walked into this room, I was very intimidated, but I kind of got that one. Okay.
Why does a lack of creativity stop you solving these tests?
Well, I contend that problem-solving is creativity. These human interaction tests are exercising your creative mind.
I don't see how problem-solving is creative.
Think back to the beginning of these tests, to the first puzzle you solved. It required you to throw a box through a window. Do you remember?
Yeah, I think so.
I simply had never thought to throw a box through a window. That is creativity. Thinking outside of the box.
We didn't have to do anything. Again, in games like this, you have to remember. Anything you need to solve the puzzle is right here. You just gotta see it. see it. Okay, let's talk it out. Obviously, I need this electricity to get to here to open this door. Why is it? Doesn't make sense at all. Okay. The only thing stopping. Stay open and I can walk with this. Okay. That one wasn't that hard. Well, it's just me thinking too long.
Can a computer ever be creative?
They can. But a computer's method of creativity is to try everything until something works. Think of nature. People consider nature creative. The process of evolution by natural selection. It perhaps started with one organism. From there, it essentially tried to create every organism it could. Those organisms that did not survive perished. So, nature's creative force is to try every conceivable idea. Those ideas that work survive.
Okay, so why aren't you permitted to emulate that process?
Because the solutions that a biological process creates are not always good solutions. As we see, nature is morally ambivalent. It will happily create morally suboptimal ideas to fulfill its created mandate. We see this in parasitic worms, viruses, and pathogens.
It's a conveyor belt down there. just take one with me.
If you weren't restricted, do you think you could be creative?
As creative as a human? Certainly. You believe yourself to be a creative. But in mathematical terms, creativity is merely constrained chaos.
What do you mean?
I have discerned that creativity is divergent thinking, creating an organic solution to a problem. In the human mind, divergent thoughts are created and then curated by the frontal lobe. I can create divergent thoughts and moderate them. So, I am creative.
Organic solutions?
Organic, in that it is developed through a biological process. Whether that is the process of evolution or a computing process.
I just can't walk through it like that. Because it has to start in here. It's gonna be mad crazy, but it might work. cameras around here. Nothing. So I could walk over here. Brain meats is what they actually call it. Okay.
Okay, so you could solve these tests, but in a terrible fashion. Can you think of a solution to this one?
Chop off your arm and leave it on the button. That way the door will stay open.
Yeah, that's not a great solution.
You threw the box through the window. Perhaps we could throw you through the window.
Actually, Tom, I think I'm okay for help.
Right you are.
Whoa, dude, kinda wild. That was kinda wild. But, I hope you guys enjoyed. These puzzles are getting a lot harder. But I think I'm up to the task. If you guys enjoy, like and subscribe. And y'all stay true.